Why is there standing water in my water softener?
Did anyone turn it off at 2 a.m. because it was too noisy and forget to turn it back on? You'll have standing water if you paused it or turned it off.
No one should have turned it off.
If there is no water flowing in or out, then the automatic back flush solenoid may be dead.
I've heard of the part but don't know what it does.
It flushes in the reverse direction to clean dirt out of the tank. If that dies, then the unit won't have water flowing because it didn't finish cleaning.
That is going to require replacement.
A lot of water softeners have the intelligence to stop when the water level is too high, because the drain hose is blocked.
It is not like a dishwasher hose that can get kinked because someone is moving the unit around.
It can get clogged with salt chunks or sediment.
If I have sediment in it, at least this is easier to clean than a clogged garbage disposal.
You could also have standing water because there is a salt bridge.
How do you fix that?
Hit it with a soft mallet so you do not break the tank, then regenerate the tank. That may give it enough salt and dissolve enough crystallized salt to get it to process and drain.
That's a lot of may and might.
You may just have a clogged screen.
Replacing the filter is at least easy to do.
There could also be a damaged Venturi assembly.
That requires a professional to replace.
It may only need to be cleaned.
That I could do unless the clog is inside the assembly.
The float assembly may be damaged, so the unit does not realize there is too much water in the unit even after draining the amount it expects.
So the float may have a crack so the unit thinks there are 20 gallons but it really holds 35 gallons. That means when it drains 20, there's an extra 15 gallons standing.
The problem may also be a control board that is not processing the water appropriately.
That's expensive to replace.
The upside of smart appliances is how many problems can be solved by power cycling them.
It does not have a reboot button.
Hit regenerate or reset. Or turn it off, wait 2 minutes, turn it back on.
And all else fails, do a hard reset at the circuit breaker.
Or check the control board for error codes to tell you why it won't go.